for the modified Newton's method. And you also should know when you'd want to implement Newton's modified method or the modified Newton method. You remember what the situation was? Yeah, if your function has a root of multiplicity greater than one, for example, come up with an example here, like a polynomial function, f of x, say, is maybe, you know, maybe x plus 1 times x minus 2 squared. The roots are very simple, negative 1 and 2. But the one at 2 is a double root. Newton's method is going to converge very slowly to the double root. Let's go ahead and define our g of x function, x minus f of x divided by f prime of x. If you're going to implement this in Mathematica, quickest way to do it is not to use the Newton plot code, unless you've already got that entered. The quickest thing to do is NestList that iterates the function g. Let's go ahead and see that it converges to negative 1 very rapidly if I pick something relatively close to negative 1 here, like negative 0.5, say with 10 iterations. Yeah, it's converging to negative 1 pretty rapidly. That root, turns out, is quadratic convergence. Do you remember what happens with g at that root? I'm hinting at it here with my hand, my finger. Well, that's the f of x's root just touches the x-axis. I'm talking about the function g that you iterate, and the line y equals x is what I'm thinking of. It crosses that line with a zero slope, where f crosses the x-axis with a non-zero slope, actually. G crosses the line y equals x with the zero slope. We talked about that. But if I try applying this to estimate the root of 2, the convergence is slower. How about that? That's because f has a double root at 0. It touches the x-axis with a slope of 0, which means the g function actually crosses the line y equals x with a non-zero slope. Weird. But that's what we saw, okay? It's converging kind of slowly. What we have with the modified Newton's method is a situation where we can converge faster. Again, the motivation is, I'm not gonna test you on this motivation, but the motivation is to create a new function mu of x that also has a root at the same place f does, as long as you're not dividing by zero. Although if it's a root of multiplicity m, actually its derivative has a root at the same spot, but its multiplicity would be m minus 1. And so when you divide, you should get a root of multiplicity m, or excuse me, multiplicity 1, a simple root. And that's what they confirm here. P is a simple zero of mu of x. And so then you apply Newton's method to mu of x effectively. Instead of f of x divided by f prime, you've got mu of x divided by mu prime. But you do want to get that in terms of f. And when you simplify it, you get this. X minus this fraction, where the new numerator is f times f prime, and the new denominator is f prime squared minus f times f double prime. Okay, so you already implemented this once. On your homework, let's implement it. Just a little bit more practice on Mathematica now. Maybe call the function h of x. X minus, so I already forgot the numerator. I think I remember the denominator. Was it f prime of x squared? F of x times f prime of x. Divide by f prime of x squared minus f of x times f double prime of x. Now apply Newton's method in the modified Newton's method by iterating h. Trying to estimate the root of 2 at 2 with a seed of 2.5, say. We're getting indeterminate, must be dividing by zero, but it does seem to be converging to two rapidly at first. I don't know if we pick a different seed, if it'll work better. Okay, well, let's ignore those indeterminants. We do see it going to two seemingly pretty rapidly at first. I'm not quite sure why we're getting indeterminate. I tried this actually ahead of time and it didn't do that. Okay. I do this. Okay, there it's not getting indeterminate. So it must be a numerical error. You know what? That's actually not surprising. And it actually brings up an issue with numerical analysis that the textbook mentions. Sometimes your denominators here are very, very small and lead to numerical error. That's probably why it was saying indeterminate there. Probably not literally dividing by zero, just something very, very close to zero. And effectively, Mathematica is saying, I give up, those numbers so small, I'm dealing with really, really difficult to deal with machine numbers. Okay. So I'm not going to require you to know that derivation. You will want to write down the formula for the modified Newton method on your homework, and be able to implement it on your calculator. Possibly I'm going to let you use your computers during the test and maybe use Mathematica as well. Maybe, I haven't decided. That's something you should be able to do as well.